Are you ready to become a billionaire? What's going on, guys? Welcome, Rabid here, and today I'm going to show you how to mine a new Kaspa fork, Nexell-IA, or however it's pronounced, and possibly this could make us billions. I'm just kidding. This is probably not going to make anywhere near that, but it is a spec mining coin. It is forked out of Kaspa, and it's not yet listed on the exchange, so we're purely focus on the spec mining phase, and hopefully it works out in our favor. So we're not really going to go into everything about this coin because I'm not really sure at this point, but it does say it is a GPU focused fork. Now if we go into mining pool stats, you can see it says K heavy hash. If that was the case, this would be overrun by ASICs, but it is running off Carlson hash, not K heavy hash, which mining pool stats. So this is a GPU focused fork, and just so you guys kind of know, you're going to be using the same miners. In this case, we're going to be utilizing Regal Miner for the mining of this coin. So the first thing you are going to need is a wallet. So they do have a web wallet available. That means you don't have to download anything sketchy and possibly get a virus. I don't know if that's a thing or not, but obviously this is the fastest and safest way to get a wallet address. It was down for the past couple days, but it does look like it's up and online. And this is currently where I did get my address, and I'm just starting to mine this coin myself. All right, so now that we have a wallet address to mine to, we are gonna need a miner for our GPU. In this case, I'm gonna be utilizing Regal Miner, as I do have NVIDIA GPUs, and I'm gonna be using version 1.14.2. You do not need the latest version, but if you're mining this for the first time and you just wanna stay up to date, it's always best to update to the latest version. So once you do get that and extract it, navigate to wherever you did extract that. Here you can see it right here. And we're gonna go to KLS. This is Carlson, so it already has the proper algorithm and everything in this bat file. I'm simply gonna right click this here, copy it, and make a new one for the new coin here. So we're gonna paste that in like so. And I'm simply gonna rename this to the new coin, Nexell-IA. I always wanna say AI, but I feel like they messed up somehow when they first made this coin. So anyway, we're going to go to Nexell-IA, not AI. So click on this, and now I'm just going to open up this bat file like so, and this is everything we got to change. So by default, it won't mine to anything. We got to get rid of these colons here. So I'm going to bring in the one that's already defaulted to Hero Miners. Just remove those. That's step number one. You can see the algorithm already says Carlson hash. This is the algorithm we need for this anyway. And now we got to input our pool parameters. So I'm just going to simply come back to here. I'm going to go into the Hero Miners mining pool, which is the sponsor of today's video and one of the largest pools out there for this new coin. When it comes to spec mining, you want as many blocks as possible, and they're nailing them. So anyway, we're going to come into here, copy this like so, right click, copy, and now we're going to come into our actual miner again and paste that in like so. Now you can see us.nexella.heroMiners.com with the port 1143. Be sure to use the stratum closest to your location to maximize your rewards and helping out the pool to find them blocks as well. Next up, we're going to need our actual wallet. I almost say Carlson here because it does say KLS. So we're going to come into our wallet here, simply highlight it, right click, copy your address, come back to your bat file, and paste that in where it says your KLS wallet. In this case, we're not mining KLS, we are mining Nexella or whatever it's called. So we're going to paste that in like so. Worker name. Now we do have to put our rig in a separate parameter here, our dash W. This will be Rabid WS. And then we're going to save this like so. File, save. Done. Our bat file is now complete. Now for overclock settings and stuff, you can run over to hashrate.no, look up your GPU, look for Carlson, and get like a baseline where to start for all your settings here. This is what I'm currently using in mine. I also use the LOL Miner GUI. That is this guy right here. You can see core clock set here where I lock it, the core clock offset, and then I'm locking my memory clock to 810. So this is what I currently run on my RTX 4090. Simply hit the apply OCs, and then when you're done mining, simply hit reset GPUs, and it brings it all back to your stock settings. This is what I find is a nice easy way to implement my overclock settings and remove them at the same time when I'm not mining anymore, especially on something like my workstation when I got to record videos and all sorts of other fun stuff. All right, so now that I got my overclock settings and everything set, I do want to double check the bat file. You always want to make sure. I usually double and triple check things, and so far, yes, everything is looking right. So we do have Regal Miner. It's going to run that here. Carlson hash is the algorithm we need for this coin. Stratum is hero miners. This is our wallet address, followed by my worker name. And we got our little colons here removed. And it looks like our colons here are, you know, removed by default. So we're actually going to add those in there, because then it actually would have told me to mine to this parameters here. And we don't want that. We want this one right here. So file, save. So make sure you do add those colons on the top one to Wooly Pooly in case you didn't on yours. So now we should be good to go. I'm going to double click on the bat file we just set up, and it looks like it's connecting to the pool, and we are now gaining hash rate. We're already up to 2.93 giga hash and rocking. I do believe the 4090 does sit around 4.525 giga hash on this algorithm. And if we do check in at the pool, we can see that Rabid workstation just sent a share less than a minute ago, so everything is working as intended. So now we're going to move on over to HiveOS and show you how to set up this Octaminer right here. All right, everyone, so here we are in HiveOS. Now I'm going to do this from scratch just so that you guys can follow it step by step. I already have this thing working, as we can see right here, but I'm not going to go through my initial flight sheet. I just want you guys to follow the steps. I find it'll probably be easier for you guys to do it like that. So the first thing you want is go into your wallets here, and you're going to want to add a new wallet. At this point, you're going to want to name it whatever you want, because it's not in by default. So we're going to go next. Ella here, IA, you know, gobbledygook, whatever. And it'll ask you to create that coin. You're simply going to hit, yep, we're going to create that coin. And then you're going to paste your address in like so, and then name it whatever you want, you know, web wallet or whatever. Mine is called web wallet or something. And then you simply hit create. And this will now be in within HiveOS. You can use it for any flight sheet over and over again. Next up, we're going to click on flight sheet. So once this finally does load like so, now we're gonna click type coin and ticker, and we're gonna put in that wallet we just made. We can see Nexell-IA, I already did that, and web wallet is right here. Pool, we're gonna have to configure this in the miner, and we are again going to use that Regal miner. So we're gonna click on that, and now I'm just gonna name this test video. So now we're gonna go to our setup miner config here. Algorithm is Carlson hash, so Carlson hash, like so, just popped up. Wallet template, you just got to click on this little eye right here. These parameters will pop up. Click on the wallet. Make sure you do put a period here to divide them, and then worker name. It's pretty simple there. You don't need to put a worker name here, but obviously you can if you want. And then our pool URL, we're going to have to go back into the Hero Miner's mining pool, scroll on up to the top, and then choose the closest stratum for you. This one, I'm going with US West. We're going to copy that, bring that in, and just simply paste that in like so. And this is where you're going to set your overclock settings. All right, so we're going to do a quick little run through on how to set the overclock settings here for you guys. So here you can see all my GPUs, GPU 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way to 11. The Octaminer does hold 12 GPUs, but the first GPU does start at number 0, not number 1. So just remember that 12 GPUs will display 0 through number 11. So make sure you know which one is which. So now I'm going to go into my flight sheet here, and I already got these. You can kind of see right here. I'm just going to edit this. Go to my setup miner config. You know, this is already what you're going to have right here, seeing how it's blank, but we're just going to run through the numbers. So these are the Regal miner commands, dash dash C clock. This is your core clock offset, which I have 300 right across the board on all my NVIDIA GPUs. This is locking my core clock. And remember, this is GPU 0, GPU 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. You can go to hashrate.no for every GPU, figure out which ones you want for each, and then do some fine tuning on your own later on. But you can take a picture of, you know, all your rigs in a line or something. That way you know which ones is which in case you forget. And then you can just run through this and set them up individually. And here's where you lock your memory clock. In this case, every GPU is locked to 810. You don't need a power limit because you are locking your core, but it's still a good idea maybe sometimes for a backup, just in case that core clock doesn't lock, you don't start using mad amounts of power. So again, just from the start here, your GPU numbers definitely matter here. GPU 0 is always first, and then it continues down the line all the way to 11 here. In this case, there's 12 GPUs starting at 0. So hopefully that kind of makes sense for you guys. And once you get all your overclock settings in there, you're going to apply whatever changes you did. Make sure you do name your flight sheet here. So test video in this case, and then we're going to create that flight sheet. At that point, we're going to come back to our main HiveOS dashboard, click on the worker we do want to run, go into flight sheets here, scroll on down to that latest flight sheet we just made, which will be the first flight sheet above anything you may have starred. If you have nothing starred, it'll be at the very top first one. And then simply click on the rocket ship that you will then begin mining Nexella to Hero Miners. All right, guys, so thank you for checking out this video. That is how you mine this new Kaspa fork Nexell-IA on GPUs with NVIDIA in both Windows and HiveOS. Hopefully, we all become mad billionaires at this point. I'm just kidding. I wouldn't hold my breath on that. But thank you for checking out this video, guys. Hopefully, it did help you out. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and thumbs up. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.